ladies and gentlemen. Thomas, could you put it Owen? Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Chambly, represented by Thomas Roxell. On my left, Rostock, represented by Vladimir Ivanov. Chambly to serve. Novel play.
And a very good afternoon and welcome to this 2014 finals of the European Club Championship here in Amiens. Large French crowd gathered to support their team, Chambly. Chambly, of course, represented by Thomas Roussel in orange, and the Russians today wearing blue. It's Vladimir Ivanov, first singles for Vladivostok.
There is over. One.
This is second on. European Club Championship Finals have been held in the Picardy region in northern France. Beauvais last year, this year Amiens in the Colosseum.
There's a lot.
The one. Ice hockey swimming pools. And this week, home to the 2014 European Club Championships. Demora Vladivostok come into this event, of course, as hot favourites. Lift a hat-trick of titles, winners last year in Beauvais and the year before in Hungary. And with a lineup that resembles pretty much the Russian national team, they are hot favourites in this match.
Three, one.
Finally yesterday Ivanov losing the opening singles and that yesterday's match to Indra Bagas Ali Shandra, the Indonesian who is based in Milan and plays correct. And some really close matches. Petya Nedelcheva winning also against Olga Golovanova. But in the end, the
Russian
top seed, Vladivostok, came through the group without dropping a game. And Chambly also topping their group ahead of Milan.
There's a while. Two,
only
five.
Two matches, two games. So a good performance already from Chambly. Without two of their star players this week, of course, Imogen Bankier playing in Australia at the Grand Prix of the Super Series in Australia. And Beatrice Corrales heading over to Canada to play in the Canadian Open. So down to a really
three, five.
Chambly, but still with the likes of Robert Matusiak, Kirsty Gilmore, the young Frenchman Bastien Kersoudi. And Marin Baumann has a fantastic tournament at second singles for the French so far this week. The running order in this final is men's singles, women's doubles, mixed doubles, men's singles, two and women's singles, two.
Five.
And it's the first team to win 4 points to get crowned European Club Champions for 2014. some interesting clashes coming up, certainly the women's singles between Gilmore and Golovanova.
Five, all.
Golovanova so close to beating Petya Nedelcheva in yesterday's semi-final, and probably what was the match of the week against the rising star of European women's singles badminton, Kirsty Gilmore. Even though, of course, hot favourite to take this game against Tamar Rusev.
6-5.
Even though, bronze medalist from the European Championships only a few months ago in Kazan. And of course, even of the only man to qualify in both singles and doubles for the London Olympics.
7-5. Something.
Winner in Kazan in the men's doubles, also that historic gold medal for Russia.
Eight.
So as I said,
five.
Even off the favourite. It certainly hasn't been his sharp self. Hasn't been his sharp self this week. Has looked a little bit rusty, of course. The Russians are in Japan, playing in the Super Series there. So a long trip back from Japan. And then straight here to Amiens. Such strength and depth the Russians have.
9-5.
For the first time this week, we're seeing Valeria Sorokina back on court. Olympic bronze medalist from 2012 in women's doubles. Misjudgment from Tamar Rusev.
10-5. Interval.
11-5, and as expected, it's a 2.2 meter tall, even though it gets out of the blocks quickest. Vladimir Vostok will be looking to take this opening point to set them on the way, and then they're expecting to go and win this match quite comfortably. Whatever about Tamar Rusev, but Kirsty Gilmore will certainly have something different to say on that matter. And the women's singles coming up, and a large crowd gathered here to support the local
20 seconds!
League.
20 seconds! Eleven, five, play!
Circuit. Certainly a test for Tamar Rusev in this match. Captain of Chambly this year. Probably one of the biggest upsets in European club badminton history by beating Vladivostok. Sean Lee themselves.
Eight.
For the Czech champions, Guinness, in the semi-final. The Czechs won a good quarter-final, but then unfortunately, Peter Kukal and Jarlan Vincent were unable to play in their semi-final.
Serves a while. 13. Eight.
Really convincing lead and a convincing start from Ivanov.
Hold. 14. 8.
You can see in the body language is a sign to the fact that this game has slipped away from him. That's certainly an area.
17.
Kamaruso
9.
Will not gain any traction against Ivanov, taking the Russian on in some doubles, flat doubles play.
Point. 18. 9. Game point, 9.
Party, I think 12 players and almost as many.
Service over. One.
It's been a great week this week. Some of the lesser known nations. We saw TBR of Iceland for the first time in recent history making it to the last eight. The same.
Service over.
For BC Milano.
One. All.
In depth, of course, because Russia
is over.
But so many
2.
Season.
1.
International. Badminton athletes. Really. So good. Almost unbeatable. So crucial now for Tomarosa, but he gets out of the blocks reasonably quick here in this second game.
Service over.
Backhand from the Frenchman. Himself.
Two.
Who is over in Tokyo, the Japan Super Series. Very quick around the court for such a tall man, even though. Again, the backhand from Roussel.
Four.
And down.
Three. Five, three.
Sean Lee in this opening game. Really, that's poor from Tomarosa.
Six,
unhappy.
Three.
Last few rallies. Very much
seven,
first game. Rousseau
three.
Starting well, but then Ivanov coming back, and that's five in a row from the Russian. Tall, as I said, and just half a step covers the whole court. Such a long reach. And again. Certainly no point in Thomas.
Nine.
Taking on
four.
The European men's doubles champion in flat doubles play.
Six,
from even
ten.
Looked like a foul, but no call from the umpire. No really question asked either from Ivanov. Such a commanding position right now in this first men's singles.
Zero up, 11, six, into all.
Nice easy lead for the Russian, 11, six. And a long way back now for Tomarosa. In his first match of a scheduled seven, the European Championship from last year. I think the best of seven from 2015 at the Championships. We revert to a five-match format, simply one game of each discipline.
20 seconds, 20 seconds.
And the crowd again trying to get behind their man, Kamal Russo. As always, even off.
11, 6,
on court.
Play.
Even before the game started, the lineup for the teams, Ivanov looked very relaxed. Certainly not a guy who likes to do pomp and ceremony in the world as much as he can.
6. Take a new one. Vladimir, take a new one.
Beautiful net from Ivanov. Super
13, 6.
Time from Roussel. Oh. And then the
14,
on
six.
The backhand side, just letting the Frenchman down. To take his eye off it at the last second. Important now for the Russian, of course, to maintain this momentum and concentration. Roussel would not go away and would not lie down. And that last smash, maybe just a hint at Ivanov.
8,
might
14.
A little bit of concentration, thinking this match is over. That's better.
9, 14. Serve up. 15, 9.
For the umpire. And then Toma felt that Vladimir Ivanov moved before the shuttle was played.
Ivanov
settling the nerves once again, reeling off 3 points in a row. Good action.
10-17.
Finally in the corner. Really, all or nothing now for the Frenchman. Yeah.
11-17.
To the net. The net just forcing Ivanov to lift. Oh, another poor serve.
So it's a one.
18,
11.
And with Ivanov's doubles capabilities, anything that's too high over the net will be put away.
19, 11. Out. So it's a one. 12-19. Service over. 20. Match point. 12.
Eden Ivanov. Tomorrow, Vladivostok gets to match point.
Game.
And that's it. First time of asking. Ivanov, as expected, takes the first of a seven-match schedule. 21-9.
Match 1-5. Vladivostok. 21-9. 21-12. Thank you, service judge. Thank you, line judge. Thank you.
Another one. Yours is working.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Chambly One, represented by Kirsty Glenmore.
It's a little bit the power.
And on my left, the Mola Bratikostov, represented by Olga Golovanova. Chambly wise to serve. Love all. Play.
Welcome back. Second game, as you can see on court. Vladivostok off to the best start possible, taking the first men singles through Vladimir Ivanov. And now in blue from Vladivostok, nearest the camera, Olga Golovanova. And in orange for Chambly, it's Gilmore, Scotland.
One love.
These two have met very recently. Spanish Open just a few weeks ago. Gilmore seeded second on that occasion. And Gilmore, the winner in three after dropping the first set. And, one wonders how much the match yesterday has taken out of Olga Golovanova. 75 minutes. Against Petya Nedelcheva, and they've come out the wrong side against the Bulgarian. Really deflating for the Russian after playing such a good match and had a very healthy lead, 17-13 in the deciding set before Nedelcheva took it 25-23. And Gilmore cruised in against Camila Augustin.
3-1!
Barely breaking a sweat. Certainly Gilmore will be the freshest of the girls on court. singles. Playing mixed doubles with Robert Matusiak. And have won women's doubles on the day she arrived. She arrived actually on Tuesday after being in Japan and Indonesia at the Super Series. So on paper, as she showed against Petra Nilevcheva yesterday. Kirsty, of course, who has had this meteoric rise of the world rankings in the last 2 years. Big goal for the Scot. Of course, the Commonwealth Games coming up in Glasgow next month. Everything geared around the Commonwealth level. Kirsty Gilmour. Current world ranking of number 16 against Golovanova's 48. It was 2012 that Gilmour really came of age, winning the Czech and Polish internationals back-to-back. The very beginning of that 2012 season. And has really settled in to Grand Prix gold and Super Series gold.
What is happening?
Taking all.
Five, four.
The plaudits and all the media attention in terms of women's singles in Europe at the moment. Gilmour not too far behind her. Hugely improved player. For this Commonwealth Games qualification period, operating outside of the GB national program.
Service. Five ball.
Certainly, I think Kirsty's going to have to get a new pair of shoes after this tournament. Sitting courtside yesterday, and they could see a big hole in the toe of her shoe. I asked her about it after, and she said she didn't even notice it. So, very relaxed, Gilmour.
Let me stop it.
The Scot, of course, one of this young breed of badminton players who perfected the jump smash in the female singles badminton. Huge power in her legs. Cross court backhand from Gilmour. Nothing Golovanova to do about that.
Five.
Seven, 5 lead for the Scot. And this really a must-win match for Sean Blee.
Seven.
6-7. As I said already, the semi-final match between Nilevcheva and Golovanova yesterday was the only match on court at the time, and really the eyes of the crowd were fixed and really in enthralling women's singles. Petya really showed her true colours in that match, coming back from 17-13 behind to win 25-23. And you could see after the match that the Russian was completely deflated. But a new day and a new game. And if Vladivostok can win this one, you would certainly bet on them to go win this tournament and this title for the third time in a row. Speaking to some of the Russians during the week, it's a huge priority for the club to win this for the third time in a row.
8-7.
and they've come here with a huge team, 12 players, and almost as big backroom staff with them. They're here with one thing on their minds, and that's to win European gold and be crowned for the third year in a row the best club in Europe. And it's a good start for Golovanova.
9-7.
Four points in the bounce for the Russian. Jump smash.
Ten, seven.
And the Russian too has a lot of power in those legs. Judgment from Gilmore on the baseline.
12, 7.
Kirsty looking to change the shuttle. Golovanova just checking with the umpire first. The umpire agreeing the shuttle needed to be changed. See very often from Kirsty Gilmore.
13-8.
Poor serve. And Gilmore, one of these players who mixes forehand and backhand serves. Cylinders yet, Kirsty. Golovanova not doing anything extraordinary either, putting the shuttle back in court, and it's Gilmore is making the mistakes. Well read from Golovanova.
15-8.
Yeah, those lifts from Kirsty way too 16. Short. Easy for Golovanova to go around the head. Putting it away more than once on the forehand side of Gilmore. Double scores, 16-8. Superb net from the Russian.
37. 17.
Certainly expecting a lift from her own net shot. Golovanova playing with confidence now. Certainly showing no ill effects from that marathon match with Petya Nedelcheva yesterday in the semi-final. Midnight when we were getting out of the hall last night. Oh, and then coming back.
Let me
have it.
10,
77 to the line, judging hope more than anything. Another misjudgment from the start.
10.
From the outset. Is this the start of a Gilmore fight back? Only time will tell. Can serve short. The Russian to within 2 points to the first game. Good defense that time. Rushing to game point.
20 game point, 15.
Fighting, edging ever closer. Trailed, of course, 18-10 at one point. That's halved that deficit to 4 points. Is it too little, too late? Starting to find her rhythm. And that 8-point lead that she built up just enough on the end to buffer her over the line. But as I said, these pair met just a few short weeks ago in the final circuit tournament of the season in Spain. And Gilmore lost the first game on that occasion and came storming back to win the next two. And all the signs were towards the end of that first game that the Scot has now found her rhythm. Singles 21-19. Ladder Mir even off with the first men's singles easily against Conor Roussel in two games. So vitally important for Chambly to win this if they are to put any pressure on the Russians in this final of the 2014 European Cup Championships here in Amiens, France. Serving to Kirsty Gilmore in the second game. Yeah. back of the net.
One love.
Out of arm's reach from Golovanova. Six quick points for Chambly. Second game.
1-8.
Again, the beautiful net shot. Gilmore.
Nine, one.
And an easy put away in the end for the winner, for the Scot. Was really on the wall at the end of that first game for Golovanova. course, the Russian taking the first set, 21-19. But the spirited comeback from Gilmore was there for everyone to see, and she's taking control of this match in this second
first
game, leading
11-2 at the end of it.
And very much value for that lead. But this has been a factor and a feature of Kirsty's game over the last few years. Always just a little bit slow to start at times and then gets into gear like a good old diesel engine. And ends up grinding out wins in three games. Judgment. We've got Ivanova.
14.
Leaving that triple more in hope. Certainly was going to be tough for her to get behind it and get a wrist around it. A better serve that time from Gilmore. And the good serve setting up the attack.
15.
Shuttle argument. Galvanova looking for the shuttle changed. Gilmore saying nothing wrong with it. And the umpire really not getting involved even in the discussion, asking it for it to be changed. Backhand serve from Gilmore.
Service over. 4-19.
Fizz certainly gone out of this game. Conway traffic in the second game after a close first set battle. Kirsty won't worry too much about that. Has a cushion of 14 points. I think she could decide to play with her left hand and still go on and win this game. Better judgment on the baseline that time from Golovanova. Set in this women's singles. And a game that Sean Lee really must win if they put any sort of pressure on Vladivostok. So all to play for in this deciding game of this women's singles. Vladivostok already won match to the good, courtesy of Vladimir Ivanov and his victory over Thomas Roussel. Kirsty Gilmore trying to balance out the first singles by taking this women's singles against Olga Golovanova. Golovanova already back out on court, ready to go. Net from Gilmore. From the Russian and the unforced error of the Jimmy Smash from Gilmore. Three, one.
Can you serve it? 2, 3.
Defensive block from Gilmore. Golovanova that full stretch. And again, failing to control our length.
5, 2.
Double action, delayed net shot. Punch clear from Gilmore. Such a great shot to have in your bag. So deceptive.
Let me serve it.
Little stop net shot.
3, 7.
Just landing. I think you can see a smile on Gilmore's face. She's the one that looks a little bit more comfortable on court right now. The umpire allowing a quick towel down for both girls, asking them to hurry up, return to court. Certainly starting to win the battle.
8, 3.
Serve again. That backhand serve of Gilmore's Really, she's worked so hard on that in the recent past. Comes flat and fast across the net. A great speed. She's viewing it around the head drop. And the stop. Crowd in attendance, all with their Yonex Thunder Sticks, making lots of noise in support of their team. Again, that block cross court from Gilmore, beautiful shot.
Seven, 4, 10.
Wrong shot choice, I think, from Christy in that occasion. Had Golovanova on the ropes. Trying to reach the shuttle.
11-4, interval. Changes.
Golovanova not wanting to hang around straight up. No, the business. And the net result is an 11-4 lead for Sean Lee in this first women's singles. And Gilmore certainly finding her groove right now. Net, a heavy slice, even though it didn't come off, you can tell that she's happy.
20 seconds!
Where
20 seconds!
In this game right now, incomplete control. We saw it from the outset, even as she went way behind in that first game, she came back.
Thank
so
you, coach.
Well, in that first game, and even in defeat, she was the one that looked to be in the ascendancy.
Please,
went
you
on
have to get
the
into that
court. 21-6.
It's time.
And cruising now in this third game, 11-4.
11-4. Play.
Forehand serve, and then a rolling service action from the Scot. Good variety in the serve from the Scot.
Oh.
so far. Superb rally from both women. Changing run of points on her serve. Put some pressure on Gilmore. Nice drop from the Scot. Okay, clever play from Gilmore, just taking the pace out of the rally.
service. 10, 19.
Shuttle out, getting it back over. And still in with a fighting chance. Oh, and a basic error.
Service 20, match point, 11.
Way to throw away your first match point. Serving it straight into the net.
Well played, and I think I remember from Spain it was something similar against Olga, lose the first and come back in the second to dominate and win. Carbon copy of Spain?
Almost. I think I played a little bit better in the second set. I felt really confident then. I found it really hard to get going. Just wasn't really feeling great, but change of sides, it's funny what sport can do. It's just, and within 30 seconds you're playing your best badminton, having played close to your worst, so yeah.
Well, I think even losing that first game, you had a little bit of momentum towards the end where you almost caught her, so you probably felt at that point that you had found your game and you were well in it.
Yeah, definitely. I was like, okay, this is better. You've left it a little bit too bloody late, but this is better. So I felt much more comfortable going to the second, and then when it gets to the third, you just have to start again, pretend it's the first set, and managed to maintain that momentum.
Crucial point, of course, for Sean Lee. You would have targeted this game as a crucial, you would have spoken about it, of course, I'd say, in your team. A little bit of pressure, but you've gone and done it. Now it's game on.
Yeah, definitely. 1-1-1-all. Everything to play for. We've got a particularly strong team, I think. Good enough to rival these Russians. It is pretty much the Russian national team. But I think we've got a good mix of players, good variety. I think don't rule us out of this match.
Yeah. I think certainly the guys will be underdogs in this one against the European champions. But what other matches in the lineup can you see as key ones for Chambly?
You know, stranger things have happened. But I think the mix obviously will be pretty crucial. Me and Robert, a new partnership. But I think, yeah, I think if we're both on our games, I'm not a mixed player, but I've got a few tricks up my sleeve, I guess. So, yeah, I think that'll be pretty interesting, that game.
Right, Kirsty, thanks for joining us once again. The boys are on court now. We'll let you back to support them. Well done.
Okay, thank you, Mark.
Bastian?
Robert, sir.
Oh, you?
Sir, yeah.
Okay, sorry.
The change was... Was too fast.
Ready to play. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Chambly UAS, represented by Bastian Cassidy and Robert Matuszak. And on my left, Primorje Vladivostok, represented by Vladimir Ivanov and Ivan Dodonov. Chambly was to serve Bastian Kersody to Ivan Sosonov. Love all, play.
So we're back. Men's doubles on court in blue. Closes the camera for Russia, for Primora Vladivostok. European men's doubles champions, Vladimir Ivanov and Ivan Sosonov. And opposing them in orange for Chambly. Tall youngster from France, Bastian Kersody. And the veteran of European badminton, former European mixed doubles champion, multiple.
Service over. 1-2.
Circuit winner, Super Series winner, Robert Matusiak of Poland. It's a real class men's doubles talent on show.
2-0.
But without a shadow of a doubt, the Russian two will be hot favourites.
Service fault called.
It certainly looked like a foul service.
Service over.
And I don't think even
3-2.
As much complaint about that.
Service over.
And a poor serve from Robert.
3-0.
Who came up against this pair in last year's final.
4-3.
And representing Danish champions TSS, moved to Chambly in France this year.
5-3.
Fresh out of junior.
4-5.
Has sparked up a pretty reasonable men's doubles partnership with Gaetan Mittelhäuser. French national.
5-4.
We can only benefit and learn from the experience of Robert Matusiak.
6-5.
Of course, Ivanov back out for his second match of the day, already victorious in the first men's singles. Tomas Roussel. For those of you who have joined us,
service over.
Finally,
6-0.
The singles spoilers shared in the first two matches. Vladivostok winning the men's singles. Chambly winning the first women's singles. Missed the men's doubles. Best of seven.
Service over.
Scheduled match.
7-6.
For the first of four wins. So it was crucial that Kirsty Gilmore won that point for Chambly. Well, it's a strong Chambly team, really. Certainly the underdogs in this final. No Imogen Bankier, who's playing in Australia this week. No Beatrice Corrales, who plays for Chambly in the French League also. Beatrice gone to play in the Canadian Open. Without those two players,
nine,
a big
six.
Ask for them to take on the might of this Russian team. Effectively the Russian national team, minus maybe one or two.
Ten, six. Service over. 7-10.
And it's a pretty good start from the French, keeping in touch with the Russians, only trailing by it's three.
Up. It's okay. Play on.
Ivanov looking for the shuttle change. This time the umpire saying play on.
Out. Oh, poor serve. Seven's over. 11-7. Interval.
11-7. Sazanov and Ivanov. And the crowd begin to get a little bit vocal behind their men, of course. Behind Chambly, this Picardy region of northern France, the home of Chambly. Only 4 minutes gone and already at the interval. It's fast and furious.
20 seconds. 20 seconds. Eleven seven, play. Twelve seven.
So we push down the line from even.
Seven over.
Just drifting outside the tram line. Good serve that time.
Serve is over. 13-8.
Service over. Even on to Sazanov. What are you doing in my way?
9-13.
Very uncharacteristic from the European champions. Won the European Championship, of course, in Russia, in Kazan.
10-13.
Speaking to Robert Matusiak this week, and he certainly would be in favour of the new rules going ahead. One of the veterans of our game, approving the new rule changes.
16-13.
Also, Ingo Kindervater here this week as part of the Yonex team, supporting the rule changes for badminton.
Service over. 14-16.
Circuit tournaments and some Grand Prix also. The new season starting in September will trial the new rules. 5-11, of course. No breaks and no setting.
Service over.
Interesting time.
17-14.
Good defense from the young Frenchman.
80, 40.
In and around the net. Providing crucial. Proving crucial for the Russians. 18-14, 4-point lead. Good concentration that time from Ivanov as the shuttles clip the net.
Fourth. Service over. 15-19.
Chambly, 12 men rushing.
Service over.
And then at the same time,
20. Game point. 15.
Vladivostok.
Game.
That's it in the end. Easy enough for Konora Vladivostok. Taking the
first game won by Primorye Vladivostok. 21-15. Second game, level, play.
The second game underway. Nearest us, Robert Matusiak and Bastian Kasudi for Sean Lee. In orange. The reigning European men's doubles champions, Ivan Sozanov and Vladimir Ivanov.
Service over. 1-1.
Crucial as Chambly gets some momentum early in this game, put some pressure on the Russians.
Service over. 2-1.
Robert Matusiak is talking to his younger teammate Bastian, just maybe struggling to keep up with the pace. You know, world-class opponents opposite, representing Vladivostok, and Robert Matusiak being there and done that and bought all the t-shirts.
4-1.
2019 team who won silver in Ankara.
Service over.
About a year and a half
two,
ago now.
Four.
In the European Junior Team Championships. So a young man.
Three, four.
Good rally that time from the French. Beautiful net return. Chelsenham.
Service over.
See the Russians.
Five. Three.
Focusing most of their attack on Bastian Karsudi. String gone.
Six. Three.
Fortunate for Chambly, looked to be in control of the rally.
Seven, three.
The endless attack from the Russians.
Eight, three. Service over. Four, eight.
This time smash from Ivanov. You can hear the shuttle coming off the frame of the racket. Robert Matusiak. Rumour has it that his long-term mixed doubles partner, Nadia Zieva,
service over,
has been recently back training.
9-5.
After giving birth. So we wonder will we see Zieva back on court in the not-too-distant future.
Ten, five. Service over. Six, ten.
Matusiak and Karsudi just keeping in touch.
Service over. 11-6. Interval.
Robert Matusiak turning to Coach Tamal Rusal, asking, "Was that out?" Rusal just nodding that it was in, but it's the interval lead. 5-point advantage for Vladivostok. 11-6 already. One set to the good. After winning the first game, 21-15.
Seconds. Bastia. 11-6. Clay.
11-6 and a quick serve straight after the interval.
12-6.
A good variety on the serve from Sultanov. Change of shuttle required.
12.
Beautiful backhand from Sozinov.
Service over. 17-11. Service over. 12-17.
Yes. Little break and play. Perspiration on the court.
Messi. Play.
Good serve.
Service over. 18-13. Service over. 14-18.
For a man of 2.2 meters high. It would be an easy job getting a shuttle across the net on the serve. Not that time, not in that instance, for even off.
Service over. 19-14.
Edge closer to taking this men's doubles.
Service over. 15-19. Fourth receiver. 16-19.
And with every point, Sean Lee edged closer.
Match point, 16.
Match point for Russia. Match point for Vladivostok.
Game.
Yeah, that's it. Two game win, 21-15, 21-16. The European champions have put Vladivostok into a 2-1 game. Six match on court, it's women's doubles. Davis Lola and her Chinese partner, Zhang.
Match won by Primorje Vladivostok, 21-15, 21-16. Thank you.
Ivan, well played. An important point to win, and you want to win this for your team. But do you feel how you play? How did you play? Did you play well?
Yes, we play. We go, have a good advantage for start game, first game, second game, and good tactic for this match. And no problem. Yeah.
Robert, very experienced. You will know Robert Matusiak. So his younger French partner, did you focus a lot of the attack on him?
Yes, but Robert play on the mixed doubles last, I think, five, seven years, and he can't have a good speed for doubles, and young player in French is not experienced, not have a more experience for this game of this tournament. Yeah. We play our game, Vladimir attack, I'm go to the net. It's
sometimes you were clashing against each other, and that was not normal for you.
Yes, it's normal, but Vladimir, it's big. I see him and go to net.
Okay, thank you for joining us again, and best of luck for the rest. Well played.
Thank you.
Ladies, ready to play? Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Chambly was represented by Elsa Deckers, Rosie Pankasarai. And on my left, Primorye Vladivostok, represented by Zangyeki Nina Vislova. Primorye Vladivostok to serve Nina Vislova to Elsa Deckers. Love all. Play.
So we're back and it's women's doubles on court.
So we saw one.
Primorye Vladivostok leading in the overall tie.
One love.
Vladimir Ivanov and Ivan Sozonov's victory in the men's doubles, 2-1, the Russian champions lead. And on
service court, over.
And nearest to camera in blue again.
One, all.
Vladivostok. It's Nina Vislova and her partner. New partner, new member of the club, Zhang Yequi.
Hold. Service over.
Vladivostok. They steamrolled everybody this week. And
2-1.
It's a measure of their talent because neither of them speak English pretty well. And certainly Vislova does not speak Chinese.
Service over.
Does not speak Russian. So you see them communicating on court.
2-all.
With the eyes and with sign language. So a very interesting dynamic, especially in a sport where communication is so vital. But they've been doing the job this week.
Three,
and expect them
two.
To comfortably win this women's doubles against Chambly Deckers, the taller of the two Chambly players. And Pankasari. The more diminutive in orange for Chambly.
3-0. Service over. 4-3. Service over. 4-0. Service over. 5-4.
From the Chambly girls. Children, how not to hold a racket, you would certainly pick Nina Vislova as your example. So unorthodox.
9-4.
Very much like Jim Furyk in golf. Plays at world level. Not always the conventional.
10-4.
Is the way to go. Vislova, so efficient, so deceptive. Especially with her drops.
Service over. 5-10. Fault. Service over. 11-5.
Into the lead for Vladivostok. 11-5.
Twenty seconds. Eleven-5. Play. Service over. 12-6. Service over. 7-12. Service over. 13-7. Service over. 8-14. Service over. 15-8.
Very powerful right arm, Zhang. Vladivostok team have Chinese singles, male and female player as part of their team. And with that, a coach who speaks
16-8.
And also a translator who can speak Chinese and Russian.
17-8.
And you can just sense the Russians are finding another gear, pulling away now from Chambly.
19-8
kill for Vizlova. A lot of strapping on the racket arm, just under Vizlova's shirt, shoulder level.
Nine, 19. 10, 19. Service over. 20, game point, 10.
This is Larry Vostok who reached game point.
Service over.
And Kasari getting a bit of luck.
11, 20.
Yeah, that's
game.
It. First game of Vladivostok, 21-11.
First game won by Primorye Vladivostok, 21-11. Second game, level play.
The second game underway. Vizlova to Dankers.
Oh, one love.
Match for Rosie Pankasari.
Love. Service over. Nina. 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 Nina.
Little bit of discussion about the line
on
call.
The line,
a little bit of indecision, really, from the line judge Moore.
One,
think,
two.
Went to call it out and then change his mind, and that always leads to a little
service
bit.
Service over.
He hit stairs.
Three, one. Service over.
Little drop from Vizlava.
2-3.
Good attack.
Service over.
Serve that time from Nina Vizlava.
4-2. Five, two.
Pancassari forced to scamper. Oh, good vision. Just long.
Service over.
But Rez playing so well.
3-5.
Unlucky on the execution.
6-3.
Oops.
7-3. Service over. 4-7.
An interception.
Service over.
And this goes for the winner.
8-4. Nine, four. Service over. 5-9. Hold. Service over. 10-5.
Very quick points here in this women's doubles. Uncharacteristic, really, of women's doubles. Short rallies. Nice aggressive punch clear from Vizlava. Power in the right arm, then from Zhang. This is certainly one of the longer rallies of the match so far. Interception from Dankers. And in the end,
11-5. Interval.
2012, who finishes off the rally. It's the interval lead of Primorye Vladivostok, 11-5.
Twenty seconds. Nina, Zhang serving. 11-5.
So 11-5. Zhang serving. Pancassari. Oh,
12-5.
Triple landing just in.
Really 13-5.
Now in cruise mode. Certainly different class. Again, power is saying
14-5.
The awareness of Vislova in and around the net. Nice drop from Zhang.
15-5.
Slightly flat. Circle all coming into the left shoulder of Rosie Pankasari. Communication. Elsa Danker is going for the same shuttle.
Service over.
Getting away with it.
Six fifteen.
That's Chambly just breaking that run. 6 points in a row for the Russians.
Service over. Six.
Again.
17-6.
Again, the awareness of Vislova.
18-6.
Intercepted block for the winner. 18-6 now, just a matter of time. Oh, the Russians close this game out. And the smash cross.
19.
Court. Clear winner again from Zhang.
6.
Good serve from Vislova.
Match point.
Quite certainly got out of the Chambly resistance at this point. Match point. Vladivostok.
Service over.
Good return from Elsa Dankers.
7-20.
That's game. It. Vladivostok edge closer to retaining their title.
Won by Primorye, Vladivostok, 21-11, 21-7. Thank you.
On Sozanov and the welcome return of Valeria Surikina against Robert Matusiak and Kirsty Gilmore.
time. Ladies and gentlemen, Marai Primori Vladivostok, represented by Valeria Sorokina, Ivan Sozonov. And on my left, Chambly was represented by Christy Glibour, Robert Matosiak. Primori Vladivostok to serve, Valeria Sorokina to serve to Robert Matosiak. Love all, play.
So we're back with the mixed doubles. Furthest from the camera in blue, Primori Vladivostok. It's Ivan Sozonov back.
Recover one
victory in men's doubles. He's now alongside one of the greatest women's and mixed doubles European players of all time, Valeria Sorokina. She's been out of the game for a while, so great to see her back.
Two love.
First,
excuse me.
Olympic bronze medalist from London in women's doubles. And certainly huge force to be reckoned with on a global scale, doubles and mixed doubles for Russia. And representing Chambly in orange, nearest the camera, we have on the left,
okay,
as you look at it,
too low,
Kirsty Gilmore and her partner, the veteran Pole Robert Matusiak. Robert himself, former European mixed doubles champion alongside Nadia Zieva. And the absolute thank you this week from the Chambly side. Our compatriot Kirsty Gilmore fitting in mixed doubles and doing a handsome job this week. So it's a must-win match for Chambly. If you do not win it, it's Russia who will be crowned the European Club Champions again for the third year in a row. Primora Vladivostok.
3-1.
Russia leading 3-1. And a solitary win for Gilmore in the women's singles keeps Chambly in the tie. 7-match format.
2-3.
In the knockout stages, it's quite simply the first team to 4 win. Vladivostok, who got a little bit of a scare yesterday against the other French team in the competition, ex-Université in the south of France.
Service over. 4-2.
And Sorokina has been all smiles this week. Very relaxed, both on and off the court.
Six-two.
And this is a good start for the Russian team.
Recover.
Chambly, easy attack.
7-3.
foot. Move forward. 4-7.
He may scratch his head. Reception for the winner from Sorokina.
Service over. 8-4. Service over. 5-8.
The angle cross court smash into the body.
10-5.
And the error.
11-5. Still ball.
For Primorov Vladivostok. 11-5. Kirsty just looking a little bit out of her depth here in this mixed. All the other three on court.
14-7.
Mixed players. Gilmore, a consummate team player. That time Robert Matuzia taking it on himself.
Service over. 8-14.
Certainly a feather coming out of that shuttle. Yeah. Looking for a change.
Service over.
15-8 and really 15-8 at the moment.
16-8.
Better play that time from Gilmore. Getting involved, hunting the net.
Service over. 9-16.
Easy winner on the
service over.
79. Very well stuck, heading to first game victory in this mixed doubles, and within one game,
89
of the title of European Club Champions for the third year in a row, the most successful club in recent history of these championships. Back in the 70s and 80s. Again, tossed to Badminton Club from Denmark, were prolific
10-18.
Their dominance of the tournament. But in recent years, as teams from Russia who've come to the fore. And really, it's up to the rest of Europe to put the fight up to the Russians.
Service over, 19-10.
Game
ball, 10.
Game point.
Service over. 11-20.
We'll need every bit of luck they can get to pull themselves back into this game. Oh,
game.
And a horrible way to lose the
game. On by Liboret, Vladivostok, 21-11.
And Kirsty Gilmore, single player, playing with the experienced mixed doubles. Player and really comfortable for the Russians, 21-11. Easy win for the world-class Sultanov and Sorokina. And Primorov and Vladivostok within one game of retaining their title now, and you would feel that they will go on and do that quite easily. Sean Lee, the mixed doubles of Gilmore and Matuziak, just misfiring at times in this match.
One, love.
right, just a little bit of lucky for Gilmore.
Come on. 1, 2.
Good start.
Service over. Obey. 2, 3.
Chambly.
3, 2.
Sensing a fight back here from Matuziak and Gilmore. For the second game. Oh, and the cross net. Almost coming off of
Gilmore. 5, 6.
Super defense from Sorokina. Oh, and then the interception. What a rally. Textbook from the Russians.
Seven, six. Come on.
8-7.
Matusiak watching it the whole way, watching it drift over the line.
Let me cover. 8-0.
Oh, and poor serve from Robert McKinney. He turns and walks away in frustration. Again, the cross net, an equally good net spin from Gilmore. Crouch defense from Sorokina. And the smash proving pivotal in that rally from Ivan Sozhenov.
10-8.
And it's a 2-point lead for the Russians as we head towards the interval. Again, a beautiful serve from Sorokin.
11-8,
it's a run. It's the interval lead. Vladivostok, 11-8, and already one step to the good, 12-11. And now you can see the light at the end of the tunnel as they steam towards the third consecutive title. Sorokina just looking for some perspiration to be cleaned over in and around the umpire's chair. Actually, she just spilled some water in the interval.
Merci. 20 seconds. 20 seconds.
11-8. 2 points now for Strongly. Cannot afford to go any further behind in this match. Trailing by 3. It's a do-or-die game for Chambly in orange. Flick serve. Very good. Smash. Quick feet.
There we go. 9-11.
From Sozhenov. And a smash from Gilmore into the forehand hit from Sorokina for the winner. Sean Lee back to it in one.
10-11.
Crucial spell this for Sean Lee. A little bit of luck.
12-10.
Return of serve, clipping the net. And the lift from Gilmore drifting over the baseline. Nice soft touch from Robert Matusiak. Oh, did everything right, Christy. Just a final interception, letting her down.
13-10.
And the Russians open up this 3-point lead again.
Bye-bye. 14-10.
again, the interception from Sorokina leads the game so well.
15-10. Oop. Service over. 11-15.
And the Shuggles certainly tried his best.
13, 15.
The climb over the net for Sozinov. The Sean Lee was getting the look of the draw on that occasion. It's still in this, Matusiak and Gilmore. He'll be trading by two. Good serve. Skill and still very quick around the court. Super serve from the Russian.
17-14.
Onto his backhand side and then placing the shuttle down the forehand side. Was scampering Fulton up, could not reach it in time. And still Sean Lee fight, and still the supporters cheer him on. Every point now, a huge point.
The whistle blower, 15, 17.
The Sean Lee supporters get behind their team. Again, you can see the movement of Sorokina anticipating the shot from Robert Matusiak.
The whistle blower, 18-15.
Robert Matusiak cannot really afford to go 19-16 behind. Oh. Hesitation from Sorokina. And Sorokina, more in hope than anything, was hoping he would be called out. And now all of a sudden Matusiak and Gilmore back to an end one. Oh, got an opportunity from Matusiak.
Newcomer. 19-17.
Polish veteran. Point.
Thank you. Saluer l'équipe de Russie qui est bien.